Why have y'all just like made a decision that I'm a parent? I can't even take care of myself, let alone. Close your eye. Okay, there you go. Piss off.
Okay, shut up. Everyone, shut up. Just for a hot second and just. Look at that. I mean.
Yo, my laptop has been making this noise for like 30 minutes now, and I'm kind of scared to restart it because I don't want it to stop. Like, I really enjoy it.
Okay, I literally force quit everything that was open. Like, where's it coming from? Where's. Okay, it's getting annoying.
Today, I've been thinking about the most humiliating, but probably funniest moment of my entire life. Early in my senior year, I was hanging out with a couple friends late at night, drinking water. And included in this group of friends were this guy who made me feel like complete shit, made fun of me all the time, was probably straight but called me the S-slur ironically, and an ex-girlfriend who I still very much had strong feelings for. Now, because I had no self-respect and was a little intoxicated, at one point I started making out with the guy who made me feel like shit. So anyway, we're laying on the ground, he's on top of me making out, and at one point he gets up a bit and goes, "You kiss really weird." He announces this to everyone. And from a few feet away, my ex goes, "Yeah." And he says, "You suck on the bottom lip too much." And she goes, "Yeah, he does." She crawls over to him and starts making out with him. My ex and my bully are making out on top of me. I am trapped underneath them. This goes on for a couple minutes.
Name something a burglar would not want to see when he breaks into a house. Rob.
Naked grandma!
Naked, huh?
Not kidding.
Mr. Worldwide.
Honestly, I don't remember. I was probably fucked up.
Yeah, I was crazy back then.
That was ugly. Came from a bitch who nigga wanna fuck on me. I said my face bomb, ass tight, racks stuck up, shack height, jury on me, flashlight.
Let's play a fun game. You might be a romantic if you've ever been in a relationship just because you thought you were supposed to. You've never or have rarely ever had crushes.
You don't know what a crush feels like.
You don't know what romantic attraction feels like. You don't know whether you're gay, straight, or what, because you aren't drawn to any particular gender. You've made up crushes at some point in your life to fit in with other people your age. You've only had crushes on a few people you know really, really well. The only thing that appeals to you about a romantic relationship is sex. Nothing about a romantic relationship appeals to you. Any romantic attraction you've ever had feels like it fades over time. You have a really hard time falling in love. You don't know whether you're aromantic because sometimes you feel it and sometimes you don't. If this felt like a call-out post, you're gonna wanna watch my next video.
What does it mean to be aromantic? An aromantic person is someone who does not experience romantic attraction, or it can be used as an umbrella term to describe anyone who is on the aromantic spectrum or aerospec. If you only experience romantic attraction under certain circumstances, you might be demiromantic, aeroflux, gray romantic, or cupio romantic. That one resonated with a lot of people when I last made a video about it. Romantic attraction can sometimes get confused with aesthetic attraction, sexual attraction, sensual attraction, altruist attraction, or even platonic attraction. Sometimes the lines between these kinds of attraction can get blurred. They are all distinct kinds of attraction, and you can have one and not the others, or any combination of them. If you think you might be Aero, I can't diagnose you, but I encourage you to check out some of these resources that I'm gonna put here eventually.
I'm still a Zodiac killer. I take your soul with the bag and a zipper. I'm a Leo who eat Pisces for dinner.
What's your Zodiac sign? Do you think I'm...
And show me your favorite tiny pointless item.
Some more specific I love yous, because y'all are sad.
If the highlight of your week so far has been purchasing yourself a little snack, I love you.
If you think of yourself more as a character in a story than an actual human being, I love you.
If at any point you've listened to Spotify playlists specifically to get the attention of your friends who follow you on Spotify because you're feeling sad but you don't know how to reach out about it, I love you. If you never sleep but also feel like you only sleep, I love you. If you got misgendered today, I love you. Finally, if you don't believe in love, I get it. It's a weird concept. So here's something more concrete. I am glad that you are alive.
What I now wake up to every morning. When I lose 500 followers because people thought my cancer hair loss was me showing off my PB.
I like having straight hair, but I also don't like having straight hair because the second the light hits it at the right spot, I'm...
Your parents want you to cut your hair. Just cut it. What they gonna do, sew back on?
Illustrators love bags of oranges. The concept of a flat shape with a pattern on top. Look at how the tension affects the mesh. And don't even get me started on making the oranges different values while keeping the mesh the same color. Yeah, okay, just a bunch of oranges, whatever. Now that shit fucks.
Girl gamers, this is your sign to dress up and take pics with your setup. Just do it.
Drop the roof and let the smoke clear. I got diamonds doing tootsie slides in both ears. Dice rolling on.
I can see it in the things you do.
Master of Minecraft, never played Minecraft. Look how my Minecraft things be on my Halo things. Look at my Sonic ring.
Good morning only to trans people who have an unconventional transition path. Specifically, the trans guy who messaged me on Tumblr a few months ago to tell me that he really wants breast implants. I don't understand you, but I think that's why I'm in love with you. Like, yeah, fuck the gender norms. Get your big daddy milkers. Do it. Fuck yeah. Live your fucking life.
The 2000s were so iconic, so I thought it'd be fun to go over some of the red carpet looks from that time.
Why were jeans and dresses a thing? Why is that ever gonna come back? Like, let's hope not. She looks like she was going grocery shopping by day and then forgot she had to go to the Grammys. Honestly, I mean, she's a queen of this time. Like, I used to want to be her. I'm just, like, confused, like, if this is, like, you know, like, a red carpet, or if maybe she's going to a sleepover. I don't know. No, like, but hear me out. Like, I'm kind of obsessed. Like, I kind of, like, would wear this. Miley. The top needs to be thrown out. The top is awful. The lace with the dots and the Bermuda shorts are very interesting. The cowboy boot, it's just, like, hoedown, throw it all away. When I was growing up, I used to go to the middle of nowhere, Alabama, in a tiny small town for 4th of July every year, and the gas station held the party, and this is what it looked like. It's giving me flashbacks.
Bro, look at this fucking snow. Oh, fuck! Oh, my shoe!
No!
You're dead ass right now. Are you...
Did we all just completely forget that I'm the one that owns these stupid ass shoes? Nobody knows that it's me.
I'm still alive.
Girl gamers, this is your sign to dress up and take pics with your setup. Just do it.
Drop the roof and let the smoke clear. I got diamonds doing twisty slides in both ears. Dice rolling on the Las Vegas strip tonight.
Hey, just wanted to let you know, the angle you're watching this TikTok at,
it's not it.
That's right. You're looking at yourself the whole time. Bet you feel dumb now.
This is a sign to take photos like it's a crime scene.
Drop the roof and let the smoke clear. I got diamonds doing twisty slides in both ears. Dice rolling on.
Grubhub Perks give you deals on the food you love. The kind of deals that make you boogie.
Oh, yikes! Have fun with Lorth than listening to people debate my gender.
Here is one of our new unmarked vehicles. I could show you, but it would defeat the purpose. Don't see a police car around? We might just be there anyway.
I don't know why people want to be oppressed so badly. They're really out here saying, please let me be a minority. I'll let you in on a secret. If your rights and validity as a human being have never relied on a Supreme Court decision, you are not and have not ever been oppressed. If the Supreme Court has not had to overturn a law which inhibits your life, liberty, or pursuit of happiness, you do not know what it is like for there to be a systemic attempt to diminish your self-worth as a human being. This is why there is no reverse racism, reverse misogyny, heterophobia. They do not exist. Yes, you may go somewhere where you face a prejudice against you due to you being a straight cis white male. However, there is a difference between, let's say, prejudice and racism. A prejudice is a predisposition to hate someone due to their race or ethnicity, and racism is a prejudice backed by the government, and there is nothing in place to inhibit someone solely based off them being white. And yes, as a straight cis white male, you may face hardship, but there is a difference between hardship and oppression.
A lot of things that I have to do. So instead, I made a song that I think would fit really perfectly in an evil circus.
Don't forget to do your little dance today. Shit may suck. Shit may suck. Ooh, do your little dance. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck.
I swear to God, this girl be tripping, dawg. One day she blooded, then she cribbing, dawg. You know I put it in the-
I'm gonna describe this right now. We got a lot of little pieces of sand, and they're getting pushed down because they've been bad. They've been little naughty little guys. It's bleeding. Cut up Harry Potter's face scar. Killed little gumdrop boys.
And look at this. It's floating. Have you ever seen...
Look at this apple. Looks good, doesn't it? Watch what happens when I kind of squeeze its sides. Ready? See how it goes up like that? Same thing's happening with the ice, except the ice is slippery, and so it just kind of glides along the sides of the container, and it does that bouncy thing. But that's what makes it move in the first place. When you push it down, you're kind of like pinching it against the sides of the container. The container's skinnier at the bottom than it is at the middle.
If you have a hard time saying something good about yourself, you're probably just too beautiful for words. You look good, babe. Keep doing you.
1, 2, 3.
Hey, baby, won't you look my way? I can be your new addiction.
We have to stop him! Throw something!
I can't! I might hit Jack-Jack!
Throw me. Bob, throw me!
Bob, checking my YouTube sub box to watch the same YouTuber in different fonts.
Drew, Danny, repeat. Drew, Danny, repeat.
But also Cody Co.
Drew, Danny, repeat.
And also Jax Films.
Drew, Danny, repeat.
There you are. It's so good to see you. What a magnificent day it is to heal some trauma. You remember our routine? Lower your shields. Very good. Deep breath for me. Sit up straight. I want you to go inward and imagine your heart having a door. Please open it for me. Very good. Pull, pull, pull. Breathe. Big pulling, big pulling. Pull, pull, pull. I'm gonna wrap it around emerald. Good, good, good. More pulling. Breathe through it. Exhale slowly. Very good. Exhale, come back. It's gonna be a good day. We're gonna make it that way.
It started with the hay, loft a creaking. Well, it just started in the hay. With his long johns on, Pop went a creeping up to the bottom to the hay.
For every white male dude bro that started a podcast, there's a young LGBT kid that was never loved by their parents that's thinking of starting a streaming career. Anyway.
Hello everyone and welcome to my presentation on comments that got me banned from commenting for a week. Number one, we have put your sister down. I don't know how this actually got me comment banned because at first glance it just looks like I meant physically put down your sister, but I did actually mean it in the sense of like put down your sister. So, you know, ban warranted, but I don't know how they picked up on that. Number two, we have die violently. This was just a big misunderstanding because the video was saying, what would you do if you were just sitting in bed and you blew up? So I commented this because this is in fact what I would do in that situation. However, without context of the video, it does look like I was telling the creator to die violently. So again, ban warranted, but this was just a big misunderstanding. Last but not least, we have, I kinda wanna punt it. This is in regards to that one really chunky baby that everyone wanted to beat up like a couple months ago. This then warranted a bunch of middle-aged moms to come on my Instagram and tell me to drop dead because I was threatening a child, so I wouldn't recommend this one. Last but not least, I did delete this comment before it could even get me banned because I was afraid of Child Protective Services, but I commented, you're so dedicated, I would just feed my kids rat poison, on that one mom who makes her kids really fancy lunches, so, sorry.